Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you radar system losses in great details. Here, I'll explain you different types of losses associated with the radar system. Let me explain you first how many types of losses are there with the radar system. In general, you can classify radar system losses in these categories, where first one is antenna losses. In antenna losses, we have few different types of losses like beam shape loss, scanning loss, radome loss, and phased array loss. Second category is collapsing loss. Then we have microwave plumbing losses. Then we have signal processing loss. After that, we have propagation loss. And at last, I'll explain you operator loss over here. So I'll be discussing about all these losses in great details. Let us start with first category, which is associated with antenna losses, where in antenna losses, we have antenna beam shape loss. See, antenna beam shape loss, that is based on shape of beam of radiation pattern. So here antenna beam shape loss, that is based on orientation of antenna and the shape of major lobe with antenna. Let me explain you that by one practical example. See, here we have radar system. So this radar system is having antenna that is radiating in this direction. Let us observe major lobe radiation of this antenna. So major lobe radiation, that is happening somewhat like this. Here target is appearing over here, and if you observe major lobe, then maximum gain direction, that is this. So in this direction, this antenna is having maximum gain, and if you observe the direction of target, so that is having bit lower gain compared to maximum gain. So because of orientation of antenna, here target is not appearing in the direction of maximum gain. That's why, see, maximum radiation of this antenna, that is happening in this direction, right? And here towards target, we are radiating less power compared to this direction. That's why some losses are appearing. See, this is identical shape of radiation, but if you observe practical radiation pattern, then it will be somewhat like this. So here major lobe pattern, that is not identical as you can observe over here. It is somewhat bit different over here, right? That is because of antenna inefficiency. So based on shape of antenna radiation pattern, there are some losses which is appearing, that is antenna beam shape loss. Now let us move on to next category, that is scanning loss. See, scanning loss is associated with scanning pattern of radar system. So here scanning loss, that is based on scanning pattern of antenna over here. See, radar is scanning area. So there are some well-defined scanning pattern. Like some radar that is rotating like this, and it will be scanning area surrounded by this radar. Some radar will be scanning like this, right? So it will be scanning front area from top to bottom and bottom to top, right? So here I'll show you one scanning pattern. See, here by trajectory of line, you can observe scanning trajectory, where antenna cannot scan like this, right? It will be scanning like this. The reason is antenna structure is very giant. So to have a movement of those antenna structure, we need mechanical system over here, right? So here digitally movement is not happening. Analog movement is happening. Let me show you how that movement is happening. See, here if you observe beam pattern of scanning, then that is happening like this. It cannot be like this. It is happening like this, right? So here if you observe highest gain, that is happening with the center over here, and as you move from the center, then gain will reduce, right? So here you will be observing some spots are there where low gain spots are there with antenna structure. So if objects are appearing in this locations at that time, radar may not be able to detect it properly, right? So over these spots, by red color you can observe, we are having less gain of antenna. That is happening because of scanning pattern. And if you observe high gain location of scanning trajectory, then that is happening somewhere over here, right? So if targets are appearing on this black line, then radar can identify objects with minimal loss. But if targets are appearing somewhere in this red zone, in that case, low gain spots are there where losses are more in scanning trajectory, right? Now, third category, that is radome loss. So first of all, you need to understand what is radome. See, radome that is provided over here to have protection with radar system. So here, radome, that is protection shield for radar in aircraft. Usually we use that in aircraft, right? Let me show you that by diagram. See, here we have aircraft, where here we have radar system, right? And this is radome cover. So on the nose of this aircraft, we are having this radome, which is providing protection to radar system over here. The reason is when aeroplane is moving, at that time, there will be high friction of air in the space. So we need to provide protection to the nose of that aircraft. And that protection is provided with the use of radome over here, right? So here you can observe this is radome of aircraft and this is radar of aircraft. Because of this radome, there are some losses associated over here, as that radome is made up of metal over here, right? Now next category, that is associated with phased array loss. See, some radar system that is having phased array, in which we are having multiple elements of antenna, and by having a phase difference in between multiple elements, we will be scanning beam. Usually with single antenna structure, we have to move antenna structure for a scanning. Like if you have a large size of reflector antenna, right? Then mechanical movement of that radar, that is a bit complicated over here. So here we can have phased array structure in which we have multiple antennas, and by having a phase difference in between multiple antennas, we will be scanning beam. So in multiple antenna structure, we have losses associated over here. Those are phased array loss. So here a phased array is used to scan beam of antenna without physical movement of antenna. Usually we use reflector antenna with radar system that is giant in structure, in which we rotate that and large size of antenna, right? But if you don't want to rotate large size of antenna, then you can use phased structure where multiple antennas are there, and with the use of phase difference in between multiple antenna, we can scan the beam of that antenna, right? So in phased array, we have multiple antenna structure, and here loss is happening due to distributed elements of an array structure. This loss reduces the overall gain of phased array structure. You can observe here, see, we are having transmitter here and we have multiple antennas over here, right? And based on phase difference in between antennas, here we can steer this beam, right, like this. But here you can observe right now, based on somewhat phase, radiation is happening in this direction. So as all the elements are having phase in this direction, radiation is happening in this direction, and this is happening as per distributed elements over here. So in total gain, identically should be algebraic sum of all the elements, but because of somewhat cancellation is happening in this direction, overall gain will be little bit less, right? Now, next loss, that is collapsing loss. So from name itself, you can understand this. Collapsing means if signal is getting collapsed with noise signal, then there will be collapsing loss, right? So in collapsing loss, if the radar integrates noise samples along with the target, then it is collapsing loss. Let me explain you that by one example. See, here we have radar system that is transmitting signal as per trajectory lines. You can observe over here, and here we are having mountain. See, from mountain, continuously there will be reflection of echo. So here there will be reflection of echo signal towards antenna, that is noise samples, which is continuously happening towards radar. Now, as if I say one object is coming over here, then from the object there will be echo signal, as well as from the mountains there will be echo signal. So here signal that is getting collapsed along with the noise signal, that is collapsing loss. If you want to calculate collapsing loss, then basic equation is collapsing loss L is equals to L of M plus N divided by L of N, where here L is collapsing loss for M plus N pulses, where M is noise pulses and N is signal to noise pulses. See, if object is not there, then continuously there will be reflection from the mountain, that is pure noise pulses. But if object is present, at that time number of pulses received over here, that is N, which is signal to noise pulses. And here L of M plus N is what? It is integration loss of M plus N pulses, and L of N is integration loss of N pulses. So here collapsing loss is L of M plus N divided by L of N, right? Now let us talk about next loss, that is microwave plumbing losses. See, in radar system we use many microwave devices, and with the use of interconnection of microwave components we do many things inside radar, like signal processing, signal transmission, signal propagation, signal amplification, many tasks that is performed inside with the use of microwave components over here. So as we are connecting so many microwave components, we have microwave plumbing losses inside radar system. Those microwave components could be duplexer, directional coupler, circulators, waveguides and transmission line. So because of plumbing of all those elements, there can be losses in radar system, right? Now next category of losses, that is based on signal processing losses. See here, target detection that needs signal processing. Why? The reason is we are receiving very low power echo signal. That echo signal is having power in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 watt to 10 to the power minus 15 watt. So here for a detection of target, we need to have signal processing, right? And in signal processing, what we do is we involve so many components. Let me show you those components over here. See, those components can be match filter, pulse integrator, threshold decision, amplitude detector, that is also referred as demodulator, and low noise amplifier. So all these components that we use it for signal processing with receiver system. And because of these components, whatever losses are happening, that is referred as signal processing losses, right? Now next losses with radar is propagation loss. But obviously from name itself you can understand this, it is based on propagation of signal, right? So here propagation of signal, that is associated with different categories of loss, like reflection from the earth surface, propagation in atmospheric ducts, as well as attenuation in atmosphere. So these are the losses which is happening because of propagation losses, right? Now last one is operator loss. From name itself you can understand this. See, if operator is operating with radar system, then because of inefficiency of operator, there is a possibility of losses, right? So as if operator is tired or distracted, or operator is overloaded, or as if operator is not properly trained, in that case there can be various categories of losses happening in radar system. So here you can observe tired operator is operating with radar, and because of there is a possibility of losses. Even based on study, that losses also is been calculated, and that is calculated based on this equation. Operator loss is equals to 0.7 into PD square, where PD is probability of detection and L naught, that is operator loss. That is how various categories of losses are associated with the radar system. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.